going to be a Christian father, one of the earmarks of identifying whether you're a Christian father is how well do you know your heavenly father. I'm not saying do you know him because he lives in your heart. I'm saying how well do you know him, his character, his purpose. How well do you know your spouse? How well do you know your children? How well do you know your best friend? How well do you know your neighbors? It's all through association and relationship, isn't it? So how well do we know our Heavenly Father is based upon how much of a relationship we have with Jesus. In 1 John 2, chapter 14, it says, I write to you little children, we're always going to be his children, called the walk of life, because your sins are forgiven you, where his name is said. I write to you fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I write to you young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write to you little children, because you have known the Father. I have written to you fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I have written to you young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. Did you notice the three groups of people there he's referring to? First, children. Children of God. We're all children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. But in our Christian maturity, some are brand new Christians that have simply come to know the Lord just recently, and everything is new to them, and they're not spiritually able to really receive the deeper truths of God's Word. Paul says that they're only able to receive the milk. The amber. We see a man back there feeding your baby. And you're not going to feed him steady. You're not even going to feed him the old term cow right now. It's too young. And so he's on that formula, right? And so as newborn Christians, they can only handle simple stuff spiritually. So he addresses that there are some that are just children in Christ, but children in Christ don't automatically grow into mature Christian people. Because it's whether or not you and I are willing to follow in the steps of Jesus as we sung about, which requires us to go through the refining process to remove the impurities of the life, which is not an easy task, but is a surrender task. As we die ourselves and live for Christ. And so there's a category of children there, and some stay there. I've had people, when I was first in the ministry at 17. So you've got a 50, 60, 70-year-old Christian man coming up to me saying, I'm far older than you are, and I've been a Christian far longer than you are, and you're preaching to me. But some of those guys, if I look back and even then, I knew that their maturity in Christ was an infant's maturity. It wasn't a mature maturity. Why? Because they decided not to follow the steps of Jesus. Decided they're not going to go through the process of refining by being close in relationship to Christ. He looks at another group and says, I write to you fathers. What's the significance of fathers there? When we say fathers here compared to children, little boys, you say, or little boys and girls, we're looking at the man. We're looking at the maturity. We're looking at the head of the household. We're looking at the man that God has called you to be. That's what he's referring to. But on a spiritual basis, he's referring to those that are Christian men that have grown in maturity in Christ. That's not just knowledge of biblical truth. That's living out biblical truth. That surrendering and being the man that God has called him to be. And so he's saying, I'm looking to you as a father.